So we at HID heard about this unique woman in South Africa.
My name is Sandra Ann Horn. I'm from South Africa, Cape Town, Western Cape.
Who wasn't able to get a national ID card because of her genetic condition.
The skin condition that I have is called dystrophic epidermolysis bullosa. I was diagnosed with EB on 8 weeks old. It's not contagious. No one can get it. It's just a inheritance, like someone in the family could have had it long ago.
With EB, Sandra is very prone to blisters all over her body.
The blistering affected my nails, my hair, toenails, and the throat and the eyes.
In order to get an ID in South Africa, Sandra had to go to the local Home Affairs office in order to put her fingerprints in the national database.
Due to the skin condition, I only have two layers, which is the top layer and the bottom layer. I don't have the epidermis, which is the middle layer inside, that prevents me from scarring, burn marks, blistering, etc. So that also prevented me to have fingerprints.
Sandra then contacted local media to get her story out.
My name is Maria. I live in Pretoria, which is the capital of sunny South Africa, and I'm a PR agent. After we heard about Sandra's story, we actually went down to Cape Town to see her.
With our team in South Africa, we knew that HID's technology could help.
We took the scanners, we had everything, just to see if we could get a positive fingerprint.
When you put your thumb on, put all your fingers on, it was connected to a specialized system. It shows the red dots.
The result was actually amazing.
What was it like to find out that I have fingerprints on a new scanner? Ooh, it was exciting.
It was great to see Sandra's reaction. I think it was the first time that she actually saw her own fingerprints. And I don't think any one of us realized actually how significant that was. Just having a set of fingerprints for us and for most people is something that you just take for granted.
I was happy knowing there is technology that will be able to help.
When you look at what Sandra has to do in order to get simple things done, you tend to fall in love with the way that she sees the world.
I live my life like you, like anybody else has lived their lives.
Loves her little dog, it's called Waffles. She loves walking on the beach, she enjoys life.
Socially and growing up with it, it never got me down. To me, it's just that what you see is what you get.
I think that for me, it was so inspiring to meet someone like that who you think has got this condition and you don't know if you'll be able to cope with something like that. And you meet her and you think she's just like everyone else.